Well, we're ready to tip off the basketball season at Presbyterian College. And in this, our first edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball, the Blue Hose opened up against the Duke Blue Devils and then followed that up with a home game against Piedmont College. We'll have our visit with Coach Gregg Nibert. Take a look at those highlights and more on this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball. We welcome you to this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball as we get ready to tip off an exciting year in basketball for the Blue Hose. Gregg Nibert, the head coach. I'm your host, Eric Thacker. Glad to have you with us. And, Coach, it all began late last year. We saw your team turn the corner a little bit. The starting five was competitive against everybody. And then now, all of a sudden, your new recruits are making this a team that I'm sure everybody's going to be excited about.
Well, we are, Eric, and we've got a lot of newcomers. We've got some young freshmen, and go with our sophomores, and we've had some key injuries already, but guys have had to step up and really feel great about this basketball team, even though we've only got two seniors, but two great seniors in Will and Jordan, and a junior in Austin Anderson who's played a lot of basketball, and have a walk-on junior in Janiel Jenkins, a little point guard that's done some nice things. So they really come to work every day. They make it exciting in terms of their work ethic. They're pulling for each other. But when you got 11 of your 15 guys are freshmen and sophomores, we really got to be patient, and we've really got to bring these guys along slow. But they come to practice every day, and they're just great to be around because they want to be the best players they can possibly be.
Well, Coach, we talked about it last year that your starting five last year was so competitive, but we really didn't have the deep bench to give them that rotation that we needed. Now with these freshmen that are talented, by the way, now give your team some depth. So that's going to change everything this year, isn't it?
Well, it does. Our practices have been better. And like you said, even though we've had a couple injuries, last year those injuries to key people would have probably devastated us, and we'd had even a tougher time last year. But we've got guys that can step in there. Uh-huh. Unfortunately or fortunately, sometimes it's a young depth, but it's an exciting depth because these guys can really play. Our freshman class is one of the most talented that we've had, to go along with those sophomores. And like I said, the compliments of Austin and Jordan and Will, we've got some experience out there, and hopefully we can start meshing together and getting better every practice, every game. And again, most importantly, we're playing our best basketball, hopefully December 31st when Gardner-Webb comes to town in the Big South schedule. And then most excitingly, in March when we had the Big South tournament.
Well, I tell you what, Big South basketball, folks, if you haven't followed it, I encourage you to do it this time, because already the conference members with some very big wins, and we're looking for Presbyterian College to have some big wins as well this year. Coach, you talked about the injuries, and we're going to get to that when we take a look at our Palmetto bone and joint injury report later on in the show. But you have not hesitated in this Division I era to take your team against some very good, formidable Division I opponents. Let us remind you that the Blue Hose a few years ago went to Cincinnati and knocked off the Bearcats, who ended up being in the Elite Eight of the NCAA tournament. So you open up with Duke. This was your third time going up against Coach Krzyzewski.
Well, it was, and it's exciting, place to play, and what an unbelievable atmosphere. Obviously, they were coming off a tough loss to Mercer in the tournament, and they were really ready to go, and really was one of the best teams we've ever played against. And what made it even better was the five guys that they got come off the bench. When I saw the stat sheet of 48 bench points, that was incredible for right. for five guys to come off that bench. And they didn't miss a beat. They didn't miss a beat. And there's no doubt I think that team, they stick together and stay healthy, will be in the Final Four.
The Blue Hose on the hardwood against the Camden Crazies, or the Cameron Crazies, actually did pretty well. And we're going to take a look at the highlights, and we'll talk about Jake, the backup center, probably had his best game as a Blue Hose in a backup role.
Game Highlights is brought to you by Cooper Motor Company. If you can't trade with Cooper, you just can't trade.
Well, it's a great atmosphere, and what was really, really exciting about playing Duke on ESPNU and getting some national exposure, and just that atmosphere, you take a team in there, and promotion-wise and publicity-wise, you couldn't put a dollar figure on what that's worth. I mean, like the football team playing at Ole Miss and the SEC, you know, station and being in, you know, 50, 60, 70 million homes. Again, there's Sean Murray getting that tap, and again, we're starting out in here with trying to get the ball down there inside. We want to show a lot of patience, and we didn't really show the patience that you needed to. Again, Marcus Terry jumping up there and missing that shot, but getting back on defense. Again, they just show a highlight there that all 12 points have come with the freshman. That guy down there inside was absolutely tremendous. We needed to double him. We didn't have a good game plan, and that was my fault. Probably should have played a lot of zone. Again, there's Deshaun Murray. Great drive and great pass off there to Will Truss. Again, good outlet there by Jake. Unfortunately, Will Truss got in foul trouble, but Jake did a good job. Good job to Devon there, taking it to the rub spot, screening. We curled the screen, make the extra pass right there. And great job there by Deshaun Murray. But that's one of the few times we did exactly what we're supposed to do. You see what it's 12-6. And then Jordan Downing taking a big charge right there. And the first 5 minutes was tremendous. But after that, and then the first 4 minutes, probably the second half, but they just totally took us out of what we wanted to do. We probably should have played a lot more zone. There's no doubt that we had some bad matchups. Again, the start of the second half, they're really getting after us. Janiel does a good job right here. You know, first year with the Blue Hose, he goes driving in there the beginning of the second half, making a nice move there. Again, too easy, really, that drive right there. Again, we get a breakaway. Great job here by Marcus, you know, laying the basketball in. Again, why I was real proud of our guys. I mean, nobody's ever obviously been beat by the points, how many points we were beaten by, just to be honest with you. But the guys never quit. They were in there. They kept doing what we needed to be doing.
Exactly.
We went to a little bit of a zone here, but we haven't worked on the zone quite enough. Again, we didn't really know where we are. Again, great hustle there by Deshaun. Again, tried to need a little better job of blocking out. Again, come up with another loose ball. And again, great job in there. Good hustle by Deshaun. He sticks with it there. Again, good job in there, even though we don't want to, you know, mess with the rebounder, but he got it there. And Deshaun Murray's going to be one of the best players that's ever played here.
Coach, despite the score at Duke, we saw some good things, and we saw one of the freshmen emerge. Murray is a player. More on him in a moment. But I was also very excited for Jake Campbell that came in and gave some good minutes for you.
Yes, he did. And we're going to need Jake and Stephen Osu. And if teams play big, that those two guys got to be ready. And maybe Ed Drew at the five. If we got to get Will some minutes and he needs some rest. But Jake did a good job. He made a nice little 15-foot jump shot. He's getting up and down the floor a little better. He just got to continue to keep working on his game and to do a much better job there, again, defensively especially.
Coach, what do you take from a game like that?
Well, the biggest thing, as I told the guys, and we went out there and played them man-to-man, and we really did have some bad matchups, and obviously it's not, you know, rocket science. We should have played them a lot more zone, and that was my fault. We had a trouble guarding Okafor one-on-one, and we jammed him down there, but we got to play more zone, and that would be something there is, and we got to get Jordan Downing some more shots, getting him a little more active and coming off either way, and when put a little different offense in so he can go either way and try to get him the ball and also get the ball down there inside. I told the guys I'll take that when I didn't have you in the right game plan offensively or defensively, and then we got to come back there and learn from that and just be a better basketball team.
All righty, Coach, let's go ahead and take a timeout. When we come back, we'll take a look at your home opener against the Lions of Piedmont College. All ahead here on Inside Blue Hose Basketball.
Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by Founders Federal Credit Union. Relax, you're with Founders. By Self Regional Healthcare, we bring advanced care closer. And Fats Cafe of Clinton.
Whoa! Dad, where'd you get that?
Oh, you won't believe what just happened.
Don't tell me you got the last Diet Dew.
Yeah.
I love the taste of Diet Dew. What do you want for it? Deal.
Diet Mountain Dew. Yeah, it tastes that good.
Hey, Hotshot. Meter's running.
We're fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge, and now with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
You're watching Inside Blue Hose Basketball on the CW.
Okay, what was that?
I don't know.
It's over there.
Let's get out of here, dude. Run!
Oh, hey. How's it going?
McDonald's proudly serves McDonald's after midnight. A limited breakfast menu plus your late night favorites.
Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you in part by Jeff Smith Allstate Insurance. You're in good hands with Allstate and with Jeff Smith. 106 West Main Street, Clinton.
Around here, we grew up in the kitchen. We learned how to cook when our parents taught us what their parents taught them. At Bojangles, our master biscuit makers use traditional Southern recipes too, from scratch, the old-fashioned way. It's harder, but it's better. Around here, kitchens have always brought folks together, and we're going to make sure they do so for a long time to come. Head to Bojangles and try our hickory-flavored smoked sausage on a made-from-scratch buttermilk biscuit. Bojangles, it's bow time.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by McDonald's of Lawrence and Clinton. I'm loving it. And by Carolina Fresh Farms, the official turf grass of Presbyterian College.
We welcome you back to Inside Blue Hose Basketball with the head coach, Gregg Nibert. And Coach, now you get ready after that Duke game. Now you're going to entertain the Lions of Piedmont College from Georgia in the home opener.
Well, it was a good job to be back home, and I was really proud of the crowd. Our promotions, Eric, you did a great job there, and students were out there, and great atmosphere for the first home game. Coach Fisher had a great win before us. It was a doubleheader, and us coming on there at 7:30, and great to play at home. It was great to get a win. We really showed some good offense, got the ball down inside, had three guys in double figures, had some guys come off the bench, and Marcus and Jaron to give us some good quality minutes, and great to get a good win, but We need to. We did know we got to work on our defense as they scored way too many points. But it was good to get a win and even up at 1-1 right now.
Well, Coach likes to keep you in the 50s. That's been his whole tenure here. Let's go ahead and take a look at the highlights, the Blue Hose and the Lions of Piedmont College.
Game Highlights is brought to you by Cooper Motor Company. If you can't trade with Cooper, you just can't trade.
Glad we could play another game real fast here again after the Duke game. We had three great days of practice here. All right. Again, we're moving the ball fast. Great. Need a little bit better screen there by Jordan. Great pass in there from Deshaun to Will down there inside, getting layups out of our offense. Again, good pass there. Great start to the game. Austin giving him a nice pass. Again, Deshaun bringing it up there and shooting a pull-up jump shot. Getting a good start there. Unfortunately, we just got to play better defense. You know, we're scoring. Again, great move right there and great jump hook there by Deshaun Murray getting the ball down there on the block. Great post speed by Austin. Again, run the play again. Set it on ball screen. Good crossover dribble. Great pull up there by Jordan Downing. Good pickup there defensively. Good screen there by Ed. Another good screen by Ed. And a good drive there. But Ed getting Jordan Downing open. All right. Again, Jaron Withers, this guy right here coming off the bench, probably he and Marcus Terry, their play off the bench defensively is why we won the game. We got to get everybody playing as hard as Jaron does defensively. Good job getting the ball down inside. Great post speed by Devon. And it looks like Will's playing with kids down there again, as easy as that was. And we got to get him the basketball, you know, more. Good screen there by Marcus. Again, right before the half, we run a little play. And great offensive rebounding there by Ed Drew right there before the half. Again, we really stress defense the second half. We get into a little bit of running down there. Good pull-up jump shot there by Jordan. Again, fast break. Again, another pull-up jump shot. Good off the glass. Great pull-up there by Jordan. Again, we're running baseline. Need to screen a little bit better. Pretty good screen there by Will. Great curl off that screen there by Marcus. Marcus really gave us a lift. Played the best defense he's ever played. Great pass there by Austin, and great finish there. Again, seeing that again, Austin's really doing it. Austin just gives us a little bit more, you know, settling down, and he knows the offense and everything. Good defense there by Marcus. Good pressure. We got him out there at half court. Again, pretty good. There's Jaron again, a freshman. Great job there taking a charge and moving his feet. And how exciting those plays are, especially for a freshman. Another pitch ahead and another great finish with his left hand with Marcus. And, again, Austin making a tremendous pass. But you see Marcus giving the fist there because he gave everything he had defensively. Good help there by Ed playing the ball down there. Good job. Pretty good job guarding the ball, making the guy go baseline. He spins back. Ed's right there, and a great block there by Ed. Again, this is off a miss. We want to take it over there to the road spot. We'd like to go down there inside. This is a great pass by Austin, and great job by Ed, you know, getting the ball with both feet in the lane. Again, we got the ball down there inside, and great pass. Again, good job, and great pass there by Devon, playing unselfish there. You can see pulling away here. Again, great take there by Jaron. Jaron got a lot of things done in 10 minutes. Most importantly was his defense. Nice job there, and nice reverse layup by Deshaun. Again, I'm pleased with the 82 points we scored, but giving up 70-some points was not what we want. Again, continue to work on defense. But Piedmont, they were very well coached, and guy does a good job. And that was a good game for us.
Well, Coach, it always begins and it always ends with you on defense.
Well, it does. And we showed signs of good defense, especially coming out the second half. I think they scored 5 points in 6 or 7 minutes. In the next 6 or 7 minutes, I think they had maybe 7 points in 5 minutes. So they had 13 points. you know, in 13 minutes, which is that's what we're really on par for. But then in the last 7 minutes of the game, they scored 25 points. And again, it goes back to we had a 15-point lead. And we've got to really realize that our players have an offensive mentality. You got to admit that. And you got to have a defensive mentality to play this game, and no matter what the score is.
Well, Coach, now we're going to get to the segment that we want to hear from you about, and that's our Palmetto Bone and Joint Injury Report. Reggie Dillard, that's a huge loss for the year, but then we had another injury as well.
Well, we did, and unfortunately for Reggie, and he had an injury in an inter-squad scrimmage Saturday before the Duke game, and it didn't give us really much time to work on a lot of things, get some guys in there, but he's going to be out for the year. But he'll obviously get a redshirt year and get him back. And then, unfortunately, on Tuesday, Deshaun Murray, hurt his thumb and has to have surgery, and he'll be out maybe 6 to 8 weeks. So those things happen, we got to get Ed Drew and Ruben Aurora out there ready to go, and that'll be great for them. And then hopefully when Deshaun comes back, these guys will be even more ready to go.
Absolutely. Can't get that experience if they're not in there, and that'll just make the Blue Hose a better basketball team. All righty, let's go ahead and take our final timeout. When we come back, we'll see what's next for the Blue Hose as they make their way to Louisiana.
We're fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge, and now with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
That's a wrap, Scotty. Let's break for lunch, guys.
All right, it's boat time.
Two-piece dinner.
Right here.
Hey, I had a two-piece dinner.
Relax, man. We got more. Cajun filet biscuit.
That's me.
You got a Cajun filet biscuit and a two-piece dinner?
So what's your point?
Man, you can't have breakfast and lunch together. That doesn't work.
Works for me. I call it brunch.
Get our famous chicken made from scratch, buttermilk biscuits, and legendary iced tea anytime you crave it. Bojangles, it's bow time.
You're watching Inside Blue Hose Basketball on the CW.
Okay, what was that?
I don't know.
It's over there.
Let's get out of here, dude. Run!
Oh, hey.
How's it going?
McDonald's proudly serves McDonald's after midnight. A limited breakfast menu plus your late night favorites.
Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you in part by Jeff Smith Allstate Insurance. You're in good hands with Allstate and with Jeff Smith. 106 West Main Street, Clinton.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by Bojangles. It's bow time. The city of Clinton, where the tea is sweet and the tea is silent. And by Hickory Hills Barbecue, for all your barbecue catering needs.
We welcome you back to Inside Blue Hose Basketball. Coach, your team always takes a trip, and now you're going to Louisiana.
Well, it is, Eric. It's part of the, Coaches versus Cancer, and we're playing Duke there, and then you go on the road here mm-hmm. and have three games at Louisiana Tech. They're hosting the tournament, and three really quality opponents, starting out with American on Friday night. We'll play them at 10 o'clock their time, 9 back here, and then We play Morehead State out of Kentucky on Saturday. Another late game, I believe it'll be 8:30 here, and then finish up with a great Louisiana Tech team that probably will be in the top 20, top 25. They're very quick, very athletic, and be three great games for us on the road and a nice trip to go to Louisiana Tech.
All righty, Coach. Again, you've faced some good opposition, and you're going to face some more teams here in this tournament, and we invite you to follow us on the Voice of the Blue Hose, 103.5 FM. That's sunny, 103.5 FM. Folks, I want to talk about this. Coach, this team is young, but, you know, we have that experience coming back. Tell us in a few words what makes this team different than in teams that you've had in your tenure, because this is now your 27th year here at PC.
Well, it is, and the biggest thing is we've had some really, you know, great teams with great character and great attitude, and this team That's is true. Different from the last couple of years, and just in terms of their attitude and their work ethic. This team really gets along with each other. They trust each other. I trust them, the coaches, and it's really a fun group to be around, like I said, because they come to work every day, and they, whether it be lifting weights or practicing, they really are watching film. These guys really take it personally that they want to be the best player they can possibly be, and they get along with each other. And like I said, is just having that attitude where you know, guys are coming in wanting to be the best player. That's fun to be around, whatever your workplace is, and you guys got pulling for you. You don't have any guys having any hidden agendas, and they're out there again trying to be the best player they can possibly be, and having a work ethic with a great attitude.
Well, Coach, we thank you very much, and I encourage you, when you get a chance to meet this basketball team in person, please do so. Great character, and they're great guys to talk to. For the Coach Gregg Nibert, I'm Eric Thacker. Have a great day, and go Blue Hose.
Next week's preview is sponsored by Baird Transport for all your logistical and material transport needs. Inside Blue Hose Basketball was brought to you by Founders Federal Credit Union. Relax, you're with Founders. By Self Regional Healthcare, we bring advanced care closer. And Fats Cafe of Clinton. We'd like to thank the following Blue Hose sponsors: Swaim Brown Accounting Services and Wealth Management with David Ramage, Bishop Tire, Pepsi Cola, Number One Sign Designs, Nichols Automotive, Foothills Motorsports, Arthur State Bank, Babcock Sports, Domino's Pizza, Streamers, Pizza Hut, Sodexo Food Services, The Camp Team, Hampton Inn. Thank you again for being Blue Hose Honor Roll sponsors.
If you missed any portion of today's broadcast, watch them online at gobluehose.com.